I'm Josh Posthuman, and I'm going to go against the clock for Fact TV. Okay, start off with the 707. Best drum machine in the business. This one's a bit knackered though, but I still love it. Some toms. Sounds all right. Now I need to shift this back onto track play to get the MIDI sync back onto the computer because it doesn't like doing both. And yay, we're in. Okay, now for the 303. This is the Cyclone TT303, which is my favorite clone for those that can't afford a real 303. £2,000, I think they are now. Okay. Sounds all right. Let's just put some slides and stuff on that. Okay, I'm going to copy and paste that onto some empty patterns so I can get a few little variations on it. See how they sound together. Alright, sounds okay. You stay there. Alright. Thank you. 303 jam. 10 minutes. Started off just with the 707, which is a bit knackered because it's got no bass, it's gaffer taped together. Got a beat together on that and then wrote an acid line on the TT-303, which is the Cyclone analogic clone of the TB-303, because the real 303 is $2,000. But this one's, it's like a 303, but with a Quicksilver CPU, I guess. It's pretty good. And then chucked a few extra beats over the top of that with the 909. Just kind of jammed those a bit. Then I took the JU06, the boutique, which is the clone. It's the copy of the old Juno 106, which I used to have and had to sell. Bought that instead. Sounds great. Put some pads in with that. And then after that, I just picked up a few noises, an old cowbell sample, some clicks of an old amp ham radio, and a weird old loop, and just kind of tried to put them on there to give it a little bit more sort of substance, and jammed it away, really. I didn't really know where I was going to go with it. I normally wouldn't write a track this quickly, but it sounded all right. It was good fun. Could probably have carried on for another half an hour and come up with something.